Welcome to the Six Figure Consulting Financial Management and Marketing webinar. Six Figure Consulting is the fastest way and easiest way for you to make money on the planet today. Consulting has become the in thing. It is really hot and it's expanding at a rapid rate. Now, why is this webinar for you? Well, if you're looking at a way to make very big money very quickly, then this is the right place. If you're already in business and not happy with the amount of money you're currently making, then this webinar is for you. If you have a profitable business already, but you'd like to scale up to the next level, improve your profitability, increase your customer bases, and increase sales and margins and pay a lot less tax in the process, this webinar is for you. Six Figure Consulting has a cutting edge management system which can make any business successful. You can slot right in as a consultant, for this seminar is basically targeting both potential consultants and business clients. We've already selected the niche, and that is financial management and marketing for small, medium and large size businesses. We've discovered the pains and desires in this niche and we can speak the language. We've learned what the customer needs and we can deliver and we'll back ourselves. Right now we're light years ahead of most consultants and you have the opportunity to join us if you wish to be a consultant or to obtain the benefits if you're looking at becoming a client. Now what are we going to cover today? Well, first off, we'll deal with why business management consulting is the best place for you to start as an entrepreneur today. We will show you how you can guarantee to improve your client's financial position day one. We will show you a secret solution to clients' major problems. And we'll give you the button to push that can overcome the client's objections and make them change from being a maybe to a client. We'll show you how to get rid of all of the pain associated with paying for our services. We'll show you how to finance a client so that they can purchase your services for very little down. And we'll show you all the benefits that you can give to your clients. What do we do as consultants? Well, we focus on the most important things, and the most important thing of every business is the money. We help clients make more money by showing them how to get more customers, how to get bigger orders from every customer, and by getting customers to place repeat orders and increase the velocity of the repeats. We'll show you how to make businesses more profitable, to increase retained earnings by 33%, and cutting edge financial management and marketing tools. What else we do? Well, the push button to turn your prospect into a customer is vital for you to actually do business. We show you how to take away your client's pain when they actually have to pay you a lot of money, and we do make a lot of money, but the client is quite happy. We'll show you how to finance a client so that they can gain your services even if they've got no money in their till at the present day. And we'll show you how you can save your clients at least half of the tax that they're paying, both now and in the future. The management consulting niche or business is expanding very rapidly at the present time. Not just because of a general improvement in the economy and the expansion of business, but because of the increasing numbers of small businesses that have come about by people who have businesses which they run from home. These days, there's something like 53 million Americans are operating a home-based business. There's a lot of people there that need your services, and all you need to do is to be able to contact them and just show them exactly what you can achieve for them. It's not difficult, particularly if you have the services of Becky. Now let me introduce you to Becky. Becky's my gorilla, it's our gorilla. It's an acronym for Business Equity Capital Integration, which is a business management strategy that we use, we've developed specifically for today's market, and it comes at zero cost to our clients, which means there's basically no obstacle for a client accepting you as a consultant for them. We work on a results only basis, so there's nothing out of pocket for the client, but we will show the client how to increase their number of customers, we'll show them how to get bigger orders and how to get repeat orders and improve their profitability. We also will show you and them how to reduce, defer and eliminate tax, which is one of the biggest costs of operating a business these days. We'll show you how to build business equity and how to access that equity in capital, working capital, and we'll show you how to create wealth. If you're interested, then watch to the end of the webinar. Additional benefits that we produce is access to finance for our client. It's interest-free and it's self-liquidating. We also will show our clients how they can obtain free capital, which is non-repayable and there's no recourse. We also help our clients develop an exit strategy by building waiting buyers ready for when the client wishes to cash out. My goal for today is to give you everything you need for a fast track start, so you can start your consulting business immediately and start getting high value clients. And that's even if no one knows who you are and that you have limited skills. All you need is basically to be intelligent and to be able to speak to people in a personable manner without being pushy or slimy or salesy. Now, why Becky? Well, Becky has a different approach to what accountants do. The accountant approach to business management is a balanced budget approach, similar to what the US government and other governments try to do, balancing their budget. It's actually a recipe for disaster, but they're not economists. Becky, however, applies economics, and as far as accountants go, it could be basically an accountant's nightmare because it turns things upside down. Becky has a better business management system than anything else out there. It's goal-oriented and it's profit management by objectives. So you basically specify what your goals and objectives are, and then you develop and design your business plan, your strategy and your tactics to achieve those objectives. We use the efficiency of capital. The marginal efficiency of capital approach involves evaluating the effectiveness of each dollar that you put into your business, each dollar that your business earns, and each dollar that you actually take out of your business. The marginal efficiency of capital is an economic term. It is not have anything to do with balancing budgets. It's a complete opposite. Instead of putting in 100, which is generally starting capital that people put into a business, and taking out only 6% of the profit after the IRS has gobbled up a fair chunk, what Becky does is only puts in 60 and takes out 80% of the profits that are generated, leaving very little for the taxman to scrape up. Now, to maximise profits, you need to adopt an economic approach, not the approach of an accountant. Getting more customers is the beginning point of a business. If you've got no customers, you don't have a business. Now, advertising is an important component in generating sales and customers. So, spending a dollar in advertising, you would expect to generate more than a dollar for your outlay. If not, there's no reason for you to be spending a dollar on advertising. Now, instead of advertising, you could also look at other forms of business development and promotion. You could hire more staff. They could be internal staff or they could be sales consultants. You could hire more machinery, lease more machinery, and you can bring in consultants from outside, such as ourselves. There's a tax angle in every business. If you're making profits, then you're going to have someone's hand in your pocket all the time. The trick is to remove that hand fairly gently, let them have a few pennies instead of heaps of dollars. So just using advertising as an example of an expenditure that you can make to create tax deductions, let's say you took the entire profit for your entire year, and you spent it in advertising instead of throwing away 40% of what you've made. So that means you don't give the tax man any dollars at all, and you spend 100% of what you've earned. It's quite legal. It's up to you to determine how to run your business. Tax man, in fact, doesn't participate in that, except when there's a profit that you have to report. Now, if you do nothing, you lose your 40 cents on the dollar. But by spending all your profit on advertising, your assessable income becomes zero, in which case, in a nutshell, you pay zero tax. Now, the financial side of managing a business involves keeping track of the money, of course, right? Now, if you were to spend all of your profits for the year, at the end of the year, you've got no money there in your hand. You have a problem, and that problem is liquidity. You need money to be able to pay your wages and overheads, and your rent and power, electricity, consultants, and even to pay tax if there's any tax to pay. So for your business to continue to function unimpeded and make sure your operations don't have to contract, you need a source of business funds. Now, what makes more sense? You could actually use the approach that accountants often recommend, and that is give the tax man 40 and you keep 60, and the 60 you plough back into your business, use that to keep the wheels spinning. Or alternatively, well, before I move on, note there's no tax deduction on the 40% that you paid the tax man either. Now, the alternative is you could pay 4% interest to borrow the funds you need. Now, if you're spending, let's say, $100,000 on advertising, you don't actually have to borrow $100,000. You only need to borrow the $60,000 that you would have netted after paying tax. So the 4% interest is not on $100,000, the 4% is on $60,000. However, it actually gets better because the 4% is tax deductible. The net after-tax cost of paying the 4% comes down to being only 3%. Now, when you spend a dollar on advertising, there's a timing difference as to when you spend the money and when the money comes back in sales. It could come back later in the year, or it could come back in next year and in future years. Coordinating your advertising budget needs to be done more towards the end of the year, planning for next year, than at the beginning of the year. You don't know what your revenue and your profit's going to be at the beginning of the year, but you certainly can see what is happening during the year, and as your income is building up is when you need to start planning your advertising and start spending money. Now you can push income into a future year, which basically means that you got the expenses in this year, you don't have the taxes in this year, you have the income in subsequent years, and then you can deal with whether you have any taxes in those future years or not. Now, you do need funds, and to keep your business running, you can borrow back the funds that you require. You can also borrow back the funds to make an investment. And one thing that you could be doing is, when you borrow funds, use leverage and gear your investment so that if you borrow back 100 grand, then you can put that down as a deposit on a house and borrow 400 grand, you've got $500,000 in real estate. If it's in your home, then it's basically a tax-exempt investment, at least up to the first $500,000 of profit every 2 years. And you could also put your money into other investments or simply back into your business where you can make a 50% return. More about that later on. Now, there are two important things that should be happening when you spend money on advertising. The first thing is sales should result. If you're not getting any sales for your advertising spend, you need to sack the advertising agency, go elsewhere where you can get better value for your money. You should be deferring your income into later years by what you spend this year, but some of it may flow through in the immediate year, but most of it you try to push in the following year. The next thing is you should have a real improvement in the financial well-being of your business. If you didn't lose 40% of your capital to the IRS and you put it into advertising, you've actually got an asset there. You've actually got the money working for you. So your business actually can value that asset until it's all consumed. Now, look at advertising, or look at your budget as an asset, and it's a temporal item where over time it's going to deplete as the spend gets absorbed in the style of advertising that you're purchasing. But the day that you actually spend the money in the advertising agency, or when you're purchasing the advertisements in the press or in the online media or television, wherever, day one, you've actually got an asset. You haven't actually consumed any of it until the ads have run. Now, the greatest sales should improve the profitability of your business, not just in the short term, but in long term. There's two types of advertising. One's to generate sales. The other one is to create brand image and buyer awareness. And long term, the awareness in the market improves the saleability of your product. This improves your brand, it improves your image, and it improves the value or the worth of your business for resale. As I mentioned briefly, there's two sorts of advertising. You can be promoting products to sell, which is virtually turning the handle and hoping that sales will come in immediately rather than later. And then there's the corporate advertising, which is designed to build the image of the company longer term. Now, Becky will handle type two, which is the corporate advertising, and it remains your responsibility to attend to all your sales promotions. Now, with a sales promotion, you will have an extra 33% of capital because of the 40 grand that we've been able to save using the Becky program. Instead of having 60 grand after tax, you'll have 100 grand after tax. The 40 is going to be split in half. 20 of it is going into your corporate advertising with Becky, and the other 20 is going into your own sales promotion. So having 20 as a percentage of your 60 grand, there's an increase in your capital of 33%. So what you could do is you could spend that 33% on sales promotion, and it's not actually costing you a dollar. You'd still have your $60,000 after spending 20 grand on advertising. and the result should be more sales, more customers, more profit. And it's costing you nothing for that improvement. It's costing you nothing to increase the number of customers that you have, and you should be getting more sales from each customer. And the bigger orders and the repeat orders, the stream of residual income, it's all been funded by the 33% improvement in your retained earnings. It's cost you not a cent. Now, Becky Management Consultants provide services in a number of business areas, but the area that we're focusing on today is on the financial management and the marketing side of your business. If you need further assistance, it's only just a matter of reaching out to your Becky Management Consultant as part of the six-figure consulting program. Now, we'll show you how to free up capital, and you can access that for a multitude of purposes, not just for spending on advertising. You can hire a Becky Management Consultant to help your business become more profitable, give you or help you achieve your goals sooner, and build your capital and have an investment program. Now, Becky offers a finance program which basically has an after-tax cost of only 3% of the funds that you take. Now, if you've put 100 grand into advertising and you're borrowing back 80, well, you're only spending 3% after tax on the 80. However, that 3% can be paid for you. It can be paid out of the improved profit in your business, and thus it's not going to cost you anything for your finance. There's no cost of funds whatsoever. However, you'll still be able to claim a 4% deduction for the nominal interest charge on those borrowed funds. How much can you borrow from Becky? Well, as I quickly outlined, if you've got retained earnings of 60 grand after paying the IRS 40, you could instead borrow back 80. Now, what would you prefer to have, 80 grand or 60 grand? It's a dumb question, but it's up to you to get the answer right. But it translates into you having 133% of what you'd otherwise would have had if you'd just lost that money. So what are you going to do? You're going to lose 40% of your profits and have zero for advertising, or you're going to have free advertising and a 33% increase in after-tax retained earnings. Pretty simple decision to make, isn't it? Okay, let's have a look at the Becky Business Investment Strategy. Having a business, whether it's a mum and pop store, an LLC or a C Corp, is pretty much the same as having any other sort of investment, whether it being shares in the stock market or whether it being real estate, being your home or an investment property. There's a difference though, and that is just the style of the property that you're holding as an asset. Now, unfortunately, at times your business asset becomes more of a liability, and that does not have to be the case. It's a simple matter of management, and that's what the six-figure consulting team is here to do, is to improve your management. Now, your business should be an asset. It shouldn't be a liability at all, and we'll show you how to generate income, how to generate more income, and how to actually build a capital value. Now, if you grow your business, you're going to produce more income, and it also becomes a saleable asset, which has some tax advantages, because any profit that you make from the sale of your business after 12 months, it's going to be assessed at capital gains tax rates and not as income. So there is a way in which you can actually spend money on advertising prior to the sale of your business, and you convert those pre-tax dollars that you put into advertising into capital gain. It's like putting it into a grinder and turning the wheel. It comes out in a different shape and form. Bottom line though is, it saves you the difference, the differential between the tax rates of income of 40 and the gains tax rate of 15. So you have an improvement there of 25%. Now, in the interim, before you go off and sell your business, you can actually borrow against the equity that you're building up in that business. You can use that equity to generate more income by putting it back into the business, and you could actually put it into an investment. So whether you reinvest it into your business or you put it externally into property or even into shares and put it into a retirement plan, the decisions are yours. However, having more money, having money, money that previously you would have just been lost down the drain, lets you build bigger assets, grow your business and investments bigger, and generate more income. As far as a resale value, we are able to increase the value of the business, so you get a better, bigger capital gain. Now, most lenders, the traditional lenders, the banks, are not going to lend you very much against your business. They dodgy up loans at very high interest rates, pretending that you got a business loan, but what they end up doing is securing the loan against the collateral of your home and other real estate. They're not, in most instances, prepared to lend just against the security of your business, unless you have a corporation. You can forget about it being an LLC, and that corporation has to be been operating for a number of years and have substantial income and assets. Well, Becky adopts a more sensible, easier approach for the small and medium-sized businesses, and also it's available for large concerns too. Becky will lend against your business equity entirely. Doesn't require any hard assets to have as additional collateral. It's a non-recourse loan, which means that other than the equity that you provide, which is the business equity, there's no other asset that can be claimed. You can even swap the debt to an equity lend. It's a corporate finance term, but basically a debt to equity swap removes your liability to pay back any of the money entirely. All loans can be structured on a self-liquidating and self-funding basis, and it means that you never have to put your hand in your pocket to pay interest or to make a loan repayment. First step, though, is to start making some decent investment returns, and that requires structuring how you invest and how you operate your business. In a lot of instances, that will mean how you borrow money and the amount of tax that you pay and how much tax deductions that you can create in how you spend money. And in terms of the nature of the spend, instead of making the expenditure of a capital nature, you make it of an expense nature, which reduces the cost of your investment from 100 down to 60. That will end up giving you a much higher return on your investment. It's a way of having your cake and eating it. So how would you like to have a business where every dollar you invest in it, you claim as a tax write-off? Sounds like Christmas, doesn't it? Well, that's exactly what you can do when you start a business from scratch, compared to, say, investing by buying a franchise. You can't deduct the capital that you put down to purchase the franchise, but you can deduct every dollar that you actually spend in building your business from scratch. Now, if you're already an established business and you've put money in, how would you like to get some early capital out? We can show you ways, or show your clients ways, how they can be drawing back money that they've already put in, and even get a tax deduction in the way that's done. Now, if you can draw back money that you've put into your business, then you have a choice of reinvesting it back into the business or putting it into external investments. Either way, you're going to be able to get a return on that money, which is actually doing better than not borrowing the money. It's sort of like having a house where you've got equity in it it's going to go up at a certain rate, whether you've got a loan on it or not. If you borrow your equity out to invest, then you get the appreciation and return from your house, from your home, and you also get a result from where you put the investments, which will depend obviously where you put that money. Now the secret to increasing your ROI is basically lowering the cost of your investment, lowering your outlay. Now this is sort of like a double-edged sword to an extent. If we make the investment a deductible item, an expense, then we've actually eliminated your cost base. So when you cash out as a capital gain, you'll end up paying 15 cents on the dollar tax on the 100 grand that you might have spent in advertising. But that's certainly a lot better than paying 40 grand in tax on 100. And in fact, if you're investing 100 into your business or into any investment, you would have had to have earned before tax $166,000 to net the 100 grand that you're going to invest. So managing the investment and changing the nature from capital expense into an amazing thing for the ROI. So let's say you put down the 100 grand and it's just a capital item. Most business investors look at a pre-tax return of 30 cents in the dollar. Right? If they can't make 30% on their investment, then they will not buy that business. However, then there's tax that comes into it. Depends how things are structured as to how much tax is going to be paid. Now, instead of plonking the 100 grand down as capital, if you use that same money to pay expenses, that's overhead, operating costs, and in the example that we've already discussed for advertising, then that 100 grand being immediately tax deductible is going to have an effective cost of only 60%, which is 60 grand on the 100, assuming a tax rate of 40%. Look at what that's done to your ROI, right? You have an outlay of 60 grand and you're getting a return of 30 grand. That's a 50% profit. Now, where else can you actually get that sort of return on an investment? Now, you can do even better, because as you get a rebate of 40% of your 100, you've actually got back 40 grand. What are you going to do with that 40 grand? Well, you can reinvest it back into your business. That'll give you a 50% return in the same way until all your profit's been absorbed. And this can go on and on like a multiplier, just the number of times you spin the wheel. How often or for how long would you like that wheel to spin? Now, you can ask an accountant to do the sums for you or lend you their calculator. It's one way to make them go crazy, I'm pretty sure of that. Okay, now putting more money into your business should actually produce better returns. You should be able to scale up your business, and when you scale up your business, instead of getting a 30% return on the money or a 50% return on the money, your profits should be escalating. And that's known as economies of scale, economic term again. It might be useful to do a little bit of research online, just Google it and see what economies of scale are all about. Now, if you can save close to half of your tax each year and use that money to reinvest back in your business, you'll get a compound return. And again, there's something else you need to discover. So there's some more Googling that should be done for compound returns. Now, the amount you put back into your business is your decision, but if you're going to get back 20% of the income, which is half of the tax you've been paying, then you decide whether to put all of it back into your business or put it into some other style of investment. Now, using a system as expenses, it defers your revenue, pushes it into a future year, And when you defer revenue, then you're a deferring tax. So you have a choice. If you were earning, say, 200 grand, you got a tax bill of 80 grand. But if you use the deferral program and you borrow the money after you've made the advertising expense, you're going to have back in your hand 20% of the income, which is half of your tax. So you're going to have more money in your pocket than if you paid the tax. But depending where you invest, that 40 grand could actually grow over time to be 80 grand, and it could grow to be 160 grand. And if it's in the right area and the right amount of time, it could actually exceed $1 million at a stage in the future. And it's up to you whether to take the money now or to leave it invested to compound for the future. But putting it back into your business and getting a 50% return, I think it's a pretty good investment, and it's very hard to go past that as long as your business is profitable. But if your business is not profitable, I certainly wouldn't recommend that you put more money back into the business. It's time to diversify and start putting money outside of the business so you don't have so much exposure to the economy, the industry, and the fortunes that might affect your business. Now, can you think of a better investment, though, assuming you have a profitable business, than to get a 50% return on it? Okay, you control the investment, it's your business. You get to see it, feel it, touch it, determine how much you want to put in, how much you want to take out, when and where. And then later on, you can decide about selling that business. Now, the Becky Business Management Investment Plan is just simply borrowing out the equity that you've built up in your business. If you're able to defer tax and accumulate it like George Soros has done, George Soros is the master of the tax deferral program. And what he does, he just basically, instead of paying tax, he invests it and pays tax later. He's was doing this starting well before 2008, and in 2008 the tax office changed the particular laws relating to the program that he was using, and they've said that he has to pay tax this year, 2017. And I'm just wondering, it'd be interesting, probably amusing, to actually see what George does. But let's just say that you've had 40 grand a year, you've been able to squirrel away and invest into your business, so it also will have grown over the years. And let's take a point in time where you may have 400 grand there of built-up assets in your business in the form of investment and capital. Well, what would you like to do with that 400 grand? You can leave it in your business, or you can borrow it out and buy a nice property. You could use that as a deposit to buy a new home. And if you use leverage of 5 to 1, basically you could buy a property worth around $2 million. And even if the interest rate is, or sorry, the inflation rate is only 3% a year, your starting capital, that is the $400,000, will double in 5 years. And it's tax-free because of the rules that Congress introduced exempting your principal residence for a married couple who lived in the home for 2 years of $500,000 tax-free. If you're unfortunate and you're single, then the exemption is only for 250 grand of profit. Some people might say that's reason to actually get married, but you make a choice, a decision on that too. Okay, the Becky Home Investment, as I just explained, is a very simple program. You borrow 80% against the property that you're purchasing, and you use the capital from your business to 20% as a down payment. Now, how would you like to have a $2 million home and be making $400,000 to $500,000 tax-free profit within 5 years using the Becky investment strategies. You do not have to pay any loan servicing because the interest expense is actually paid out of the increased profit in your business, which Becky helps you generate. So there's zero cost to have a $2 million property. How many would you like? Now, you have to obviously be making a profit in your business. If your business is not making enough profit to do that, well, that's reason for one, joining us as a consultant, or two, enlisting our services as a client. Now, the financial options are, you can have 33% increase in your retained earnings. You can spend it on advertising, you can spend it on investments, you can reinvest it into your company, you can put it outside and divert it to wherever you want. It's your decision. You could let Becky invest it for you tax-free. So you could have it compounding. If it was 40 grand that you had, you could be compounding that in external investments tax-free, and you can access it at any time you want. Obviously, you need to be concerned for the minimum period of time funds need to be invested in any sort of vehicle. So it's not going to be held in cash, it's going to be generating a return. So it's not like you draw the money out at a instant, but by giving sufficient notice, then you plan for the withdrawal. And when you borrow money out rather than cash it out, then you don't pay tax on the borrowings, you don't pay tax on loans. So there are ways that you can take the money out without paying tax on what you've earned, or what the investment's earned. Right? Now, if you invest the money wisely, we can help you build a list of waiting buyers that will pay cash for your business at some time down that track when you need it. Now, your exit strategy should start day one. It is the moment or the day that you set up in business. You should have a business plan. You should know how you're actually going to get out of that business with money. Your business should be worth more over time if you've been operating it at a profit. You've built up image, reputation, and intellectual property, and your business has a value based generally on a multiple of the recurring income. Now, if what we've been doing is manage your tax, we may not be showing sufficient income for your business to have full value. So when it comes time to you looking at exiting, then we need to plan and manage that process. And it could be we turn around and have you pay tax for, say, 3 years, which would be sufficient time to prove the viability and profitability of your business to intending buyers. Now, there's an amazing benefit for six-figure consultants because we help you manage your earnings tax effectively. We give you the same opportunity that you're providing for your clients, and the basic proposition is we improve your bottom line, and your bottom line can be improved just as a basic formula. Half of the money that you plan to flush down the drain, we can actually save for you. So if you're taking a 40-cent tax rate on 100 grand, there's 20 grand there that you basically can have, or you can give up 40 grand to the tax office. The choice is yours. Now, the tax management program requires you to discover the secrets and the keys which we'll actually give to you so that you can improve your net earnings by 20 grand. Now, that increased retained earnings is massive when you're looking at a percentage, but the next thing you need to do is look at what that 20 grand could yield by investing it into your business and then getting, say, a 50% return by in having it invested in your business. So it's hard to do the maths, I know, and the best way to actually see what the results are is by doing it and then actually see your results materialise rather than contemplating it like you might be thinking of your navel. Now, we show you a way to overcome all client objections. There are two approaches. The first approach is we'll give them a guarantee. It's a 100% money back guarantee which reduces the risks entirely of them doing business with you. We're one of the few consulting firms, in fact, that will provide this money back guarantee, but we've really got nothing to lose. The product that we have to purchase, we don't have stocking, we don't have overheads. In fact, we don't operate from offices, we operate from virtual service offices, so the overheads are minimal. We don't have staff, right? So what is it costing you to give a money back guarantee? If you have to give the money back, okay, you've had the use of the money for the interim, you put it into a fixed interest deposit until the client's happy with your services, and then we can unlock it. But basically, we give them a 100% money back guarantee. The next thing, though, is what we do is we put money in their hand. I remember seeing a skit with Benny Hill years ago. He was a ticket collector, and he said, in terms of all the people that burst through without paying, he said, they burst through by putting money in my hand. It's amazing. That's what we can also do for your clients. We can actually put money in their hand. A guarantee of any money that they give us, we'll give back to them, and we also guarantee that we'll give them money. Unbeatable, two unbeatable propositions. And there's zero cost when it's done the right way. Now, we also provide financing. You provide financing for all your clients. Now, you don't have to provide financing. If a client is quite happy to pay you their fees straight up, great. You should actually look at billing them, which improves their liquidity. It's very hard for them to find all of our fees in one go in their till. So you bill them on a monthly or quarterly basis. But the other option is you can provide 90% finance. We would suggest that you have them give you 10% just on good faith. There's money is sort of like skin in the game, which means that they've actually committed. It's like when you have a contract, you have the offer and acceptance, but to make sure it's a valid contract, there must be consideration, and that's why the client should be paying you 10%. Although percentage is variable, you can change it at your discretion. You might bring it down to 5%, or in some instances you might want to increase it to 20%, cause the client a bit more pain. Yeah. Either way, though, we provide 100% money back guarantee, so there's no risk for your clients to accept your services. Now, what could you be earning? Well, there's no secret that six-figure consulting is highly lucrative. The minimum fee that our clients are generally paying is around $20,000 a year. And the average is closer to $30,000 a year. We generally split that with our consultants. We have particular ways of doing the splits, and we structure it tax effectively. I'm not going to go into the particulars in this video, but obviously once you become a consultant, you'll be shown how it all works. Now, the penny should have dropped by now if you're still watching. If you're serious about money, you'll know that you need Becky in your life, or at least you need Becky in your business. Now, if you'd like to discuss how Becky's strategies can be applied in your business, or to join us as being a consultant, all you need do is connect for an obligation, there's no obligation. You can ask the questions, we'll give you the answers, and then we can both make a decision.
Whether you and I, or you and our six-figure consulting team, are a good fit, without it costing you a dime to find out. Now, you know that you need Becky in your business at least. Now, Becky can make business better. To recap, it's the business equity capital integration that is the key to our management strategy. There is zero cost to have Becky working for you for any business. It's designed to increase the number of customers, which basically gives you a profit day one. It also gets bigger orders from customers and you get repeat sales. And these are all the things that businesses are looking for. We improve the profitability from businesses virtually the instant we start working for you, and we reduce your tax. So you basically can start getting half of your tax back day one, and you can start building equity in your business. You start creating an asset and you start creating wealth. Now, I don't know what's happened there with the typo. I think it says use and promote Becky, right? So whether you wish to be a client or become a consultant with us, you need Becky. So what's next? Well, the next move is up to you. As long as you're not a dreamer, you can see the benefit of Becky. You should know Becky is for you, in which case, follow up without delay. We have a large number of people interested in what we're doing, both as clients and also for consultant roles. And we generally turn away about 10 out of every 15 applicants. So that means you've got a 1 in 3 chance of getting in. Now we're going to ask you a few questions so that we can sort out whether you would be a good fit, and you too will be asking us some questions so you can make the right decisions as well. It's not just about the money, it's also about who you're working with and how you're working, whether you're happy with the arrangements. Now we're looking at filling 5 spaces every month. 2 are usually already taken because of spillover of the previous month. So means then we're really looking at 3 new people immediately that we can accommodate now. So if you wish to be a six-figure consultant or you would like to have our services, avoid disappointment by taking action now. All you need to do is to click underneath, but first decide, are you looking to be a client, are you looking to be a business partner, or looking at being both? So proceed now, click underneath, and then we'll make a personal consultation where you can see the strategies that could be applied to your business immediately. Thank you for the time that you've spent listening to the and watching the video. Look forward to hearing from you shortly. Goodbye for now.